great day to come to the house of the Lord. The sun's shining on the outside. We want the S-O-N sun shining on the inside, don't we? Praise God. Let's have a wonderful time in the house of the Lord today. Praise God. Sing this little song with us.
Yeah.
Y'all believe it?
Yes.
Praise God. One of the most popular songs, gospel songs in 1970 was, I believe he's coming back like he said. Praise the Lord. One day he's coming. Hallelujah. Worship the Lord with us today. Thank God.
You have to say, if you're here this morning, God's been good. If you woke up this morning and you've got a heartbeat in your chest, God's been good. Because there's a lot of people that get that opportunity. There's a lot of people that's outside the walls of this church that need what you're in right now. God has been good to you to not only wake you up this morning, not only give you the blessings that you've got, but to get you here and in the presence of God where you can be worked on and molded and refreshed and renewed from the week that you've had. He has been good. No matter sun or rain, your life should celebrate. He has been good.
Thank God. Yes, he has.
Proclaim.
because you are good. You are good to me. Yeah. I sing because you are good.
And I dance
because you are good.
And I shout
because you are good. You are good to me.
And I sing because you are good. And I dance because you are good. And I shout
because you are good. You are good to me.
And I sing
because you are good.
And I dance
because you are good,
and I shout
because you are good. You are good to me.
Yeah! Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Thank God. Thank God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise.
Wow! Even when you think about Job and all of his distress and all the stuff that he went through. Lost his homes, children, everything that he had. He still said, Lord, you're good. Wow. And then God ended up restoring everything that he had lost. How many of us, when we're going through terrible times in our life, can say, God, you are good. But he knows what's best for us, doesn't he? He knows how he's going to bring us through that situation. Lord, you are good. Hallelujah. Give him a hand clap of praise. Yeah. Hallelujah. So when I hear talks about it, Lord, you unravel me sometimes. Say it, would you?
Miami till all my fears are gone.
time you're going through a trial, all you can do is just groan.
Yes.
Y'all been there?
Yes.
And then you start thinking about the goodness of the Lord and say, God, wow, look what way you made for the Israelites, and you love me just as much as you love them.
Yes.
Lord, you split the sea so I can walk right there. Lord, you made a way for me today that just seemed like there was no way.
Yes.
Lord, you healed my body when the doctor said I couldn't make it through, Lord. God, you done how much you care for me. That'll pick you up out of depression, won't it?
Yes, it will.
Yes.
Oh, poor me. Oh. Yeah, but there's a good part coming.
Yes, there is.
Lord, you split the sea. Yes. Right. My fears are drowned in perfect. You rescued me and I will stand and see. Shape the car was in. I knew the windows were busted and windshield and all that back glass. But the whizzling ended up laying on top of the car. Couldn't get out, gasoline poured in. And I thought just any moment, you know, that we could burn up in that car. And, you know, you don't think about a whole lot of stuff right then except just getting out. And I saw a little window right beside it, and I unlatched it, and it was one of them windows, you know, that opens about 3 inches, and had a latch on it, and I was trying to get out, and I saw a man's feet outside the window, and I told him to pull on the window, and he pulled, and we busted the latch loose, and we climbed up that side window. You know, you think about things, and a little bit later, you think about, wow, Lord, you left me here for a reason. You rescued me, Lord. How many of y'all ever been rescued?
Yeah.
You don't know how it happened. You should have been dead, but you were rescued. Y'all, let me tell you what. One day I was lost in my sins.
Yes.
But the Lord reached down, saw fit to call my name and rescued me. Now I can stand and sing, I'm a child of God. You know, the thing about the Lord is He knows all things and He sees our future. He knows why He's leaving us here. I'm glad He chose to leave me here. I would never have been here. But thank God He chose to rescue me. And some of you, I think you can sing this song today. He rescued me. I can stand and sing that He rescued me. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. I am a child of God. What does that mean? That means the Lord loves you so much He's got His arm of protection around you. He ain't let nothing happen to you. When the doctor says it's over, it's finished, it's done, not if God says it ain't.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Oh, I can stand and sing, I am a child of God. Sister Wilma, you can sing that, can't you? I am a child of God. I should have been dead, but I'm a child of God. Hallelujah. Now here's one that says, I should have been dead, but I'm a child of God. Woo, I'm no longer a slave to fear. Hallelujah. But I am a child of God. Hallelujah. We've got so much to be thankful for. No wonder we're saying He's good.
Amen.
He's awesome.
Yes.
We need to go beyond that. He's awesome.
Yes.
Somebody said, my God is an awesome God. Woo, He is, isn't He? Oh, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We're going to go to the Lord in prayer today. There's a lot of people that are sick and need God to touch them. Sister Andrea called, and she didn't want to get everybody else sick. She was not feeling too well, and she didn't know what she might be coming down with, some kind of stomach bug, so she stayed at home today, but asked for prayer. So let's remember her. We miss her singing on the praise team. Pray for Brother Tim out there. He's hurt his foot, and we had to let him off today, not sing on the praise team, but we pray that he gets well real quick. We need him back.
Amen.
And look around. There's a lot of empty seats today because people are sick. Let's pray that God would touch them. George is sick again today. Let's pray for him that the Lord would just touch his body. We miss them. We miss anybody that's not here. I think James and Paula might have taken a day or two little vacation up in the mountains, so let's remember them. Still remember Brother Philip. God is working.
Yes.
But we need Him to continue to work and heal Him. We just praise the Lord that He's brought Him this far. Oh, God, He's a child of the King. God's going to bring Him. We're believing for complete restoration. Believe with me, would you? It's just believe that God's going to completely restore him. Do you have a need? Maybe you want to raise your hand about a need today. Look at all these needs. Know anybody that's sick? Oh, there's sickness everywhere. Let's just agree together right now, could we? That God's going to touch them and raise them up. Lord, we come to you right now. We got friends and family members that are sick. Lord, they're diseased in their bodies. We're praying for healing right now. Some have cancer, Lord, and other disease, heart problems. God, you're a healer right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we stand on your word. We wouldn't be here, Lord, except you healed us. I wouldn't be here except you healed my body, Lord, and I praise you for that. Lord, you're the same God yesterday, today, and forever. You're a God that does not change. And I praise you for that, God. And I ask that you would move in every one of these needs. Every hand, Lord, that was raised represented a need, God. And we're asking that you would just touch today. In the mighty name of Jesus, raise up that one, Lord, that's going through terrible times, Lord. And those that are suffering, God, raise them up and strengthen them, oh God. Lord, those that have lost a loved one, we're praying that you would comfort them right now, Lord. With your peace, oh God, you're able, Lord, to just speak peace to their life right now and comfort, oh God, in Jesus' name, Lord. Let every need be supplied, Lord. I pray, God, those that are suffering because of financial debt, Lord, that you would touch them and help them and raise them up, Lord, in the name of Jesus. God, there's nothing that you can't do for us, Lord. You just told us to ask. And we're asking, Lord, that you would move now in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord. Grant our request, Lord, in the name of the Lord Jesus. Heal and move and touch right now, Lord. In Jesus' name, oh God, we give you praise for it. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Praise God. Wonderful Savior. Thank you, Jesus. You can be seated if you want to. Praise God. Just afraid, I know you've got a testimony, so let's go ahead and stand up and tell us all the good stuff. Praise God.
Yes.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
But he has a purpose for taking
yes, he does.
His time. There's not been a day since Phil's been down there that I have not witnessed to someone. There's
praise
not been
God.
A day that someone hasn't heard us pray there.
Yeah.
There's not been a day I haven't hugged someone's neck, looted somebody, and prayed.
Jesus.
Yes.
So God has a purpose for us being there so long. But I know at the end of it, he's going to raise him up. He's going to be
yes,
right
he
there
yes,
raising his head.
Yes.
Him. Like, I am just yes, going to thank him for everything he's done.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
And I thank you all for your prayers.
Yes.
And lifting up, I feel it every single day.
Thank you, praise Jesus. Our Lord. Thank you,
yes,
Jesus.
There are so many people that have been praying for him. 4 to 5 different churches.
That's right.
Come together and are praying for him
yes,
all the time.
Amen.
God's called us to prayer.
Yes,
and
amen.
And I believe that this is just one little tool
that's
that
right,
used to bring us to prayer.
Amen.
Amen.
That's great.
He's not going to take it from me. He gave it to me. He was
all
a
right,
blessing to me. And I believe he's going to stay with me.
Amen.
And he's going to work for this Lord that loves him so much.
Yes.
Thank
God.
I thank God so much.
Yes. Yes.
And I thank God for the doctors and the nurses that he has placed where they are. Thank God for the Chattanooga.
Right.
Some of the nurses are so wonderful and love and and I thank him for giving us that.
Amen.
And I'm just very grateful this morning to be a child of God.
Hallelujah.
And to know
yes,
that I can come to him in my scary moments.
Yes.
The moments when I thought I was going to lose my husband when they told me he had a stroke. That's just one more step.
Yeah.
We're going to overcome it.
That's right.
So I'm thankful.
Amen.
That I draw from my God.
Yes, that's right.
And I thank you so much.
Amen. Amen.
Lord,
praise
you.
God. The young woman just came down to Brother Philip and her family and sister Brenda, that the Lord would give her strength through this. And Lord, the way God has made a way, let her get to be off and be with him. She should have been working, but God let her off, and then her daughter getting to take off. And God just worked it all out. It's amazing when you put things in the hand of. Well, we're his child.
Yes, right.
He wants to do good things for us.
Yes, amen.
Amen. Just ask him, and he'll give good things to us. Praise God. Anybody else want to testify this morning? Yes.
Walk through a dark place and you come out of that,
you know God in a different sense. I just love and appreciate Him for all He's done for me.
Amen.
For what He's doing for me.
Praise the Lord. Yes, amen. Amen.